Now that you've gone through how to use the sim to collect the distances, I'm going to show you or just talk to you about calculating the rate. So first of all, remember that you are collecting the distances for these times, 50 million years, 100 million years, 150 million years, and 200 million years, which on the chart, you'll put in the time. You'll collect the distances from the sim, and then in calculating, this is where you're going to calculate the rate. So here's the example that the slides are giving you. So we're going to start here. That to calculate the rate that the plates are moving, you first need to find out how far apart they moved after millions of years, which is the distance. And you're going to divide that distance by the number of years. So in this example, so here it is, the formula, rate equals distance divided by time. So in this example, you can see that it was 40 million years. Let me come over to this one. 40 million years is the amount of time, and it is 985 kilometers, the distance between one and two. So you would click on two or one, and it will show you the distance between them. So the second number, and that's what you're gonna put on the chart. So I'm gonna show you the chart first. So notice how here's the examples, 40, some part of me, it's 953 kilometers. So you would come back here. You're going to the 953 kilometers is the number that is the distance, and 40 million years is the number that is the time. So it will be 953 kilometers divided by 40 million years. So you can use a calculator, you can use scrap paper to figure it out. So you do 953 divided by 40, and you're gonna get 23.8 kilometers per year. So that's what you would write over here, 23.8. So that's the example. This isn't one of the years that you have to follow. You have to do 50, 100, 150, and 200 million years. In the next video, I'll be using the sim to do those, to find the distances for each of the times. In case you couldn't get into the sim or weren't using the sim, you could use my data to fill in the chart. So remember, if you have questions, please feel free to email me or drop by during office hours.